Hello, StarCraft fans! This is Falcon Paladin coming to you with yet another daily Legacy of the Void upload. This is game one in a best of five between SOS and Nurchio on Dusk Towers. Yes, this is also from Kings of the Craft. Go over to youtube.com/c/rootgamingtv to find more of these games. Go ahead and subscribe to them because Root Gaming is an excellent, excellent esports organization. They have my respect. And tell them that Falcon Paladin sent you. In the top side of Dusk Towers, we have the red Protoss player. It is SOS. Representing Jin Air Green Wings. And representing Euronix Gaming, it is the blue Zerg player, Nurchio. Yes, I know it says Acer, but according to Team Liquid, he's playing for Euronix, so probably should update that handle, but whatever at this point. Everybody knows, and that's really what matters here. So it's going to be a 5-game PVZ here. Again, this could be a 3-0. This could be a 3-1. It could be a 3-2, but I think those are the only options available. So, hey, stick around for the whole darn thing. I'll cast one of these every single night. 5 p.m. Eastern time. That could be morning where you are, depending how things go. But basically, once every night for the next 5 days, we'll get one of these games all the way until the series is over. So I'm not going to spoil anything for you, but this is a pretty darn good series. Again, PVZs, I love this so much. I don't get a lot of attention with it on my channel for some reason. PVT seems to be more popular. ZVT as well. But PVZ just has so many different things you can do. It seems like every unit is viable in this matchup. There's really nothing that is just completely off the table. Unless maybe you count Colossus just because they were nerfed on their damage a while ago. But other than that, I'm just hard-pressed to think of something you never make against Protoss in the situation or against Zerg in the situation. But it looks like it was a gateway expand here from SOS moving into the Nexus there. And a hatch first here on the low ground from Nurchio into a pool and no gas quite yet. So this pylon is blocking off this potential for a third base. Super annoying there. The drone takes a couple shots at it and decides to go back home. He's going to leave the Zerglings to take care of that one. But the good thing about this, it does cost 100 minerals that SOS is going to lose. But what it means is any Lings that come out have to come back here and kill this first before heading out to harass. So it just gives SOS a little bit more time to get his wall up, which it shouldn't be much of a concern, as there it is. The Cyber Core pops right on up there. And a Zealot's actually on the way to hold this line. So SOS really worried about early Ling harassment from Nurchio. Although he has scouted, so I don't know what he's concerned about there. The gas is coming in. There go the Lings. And see, they're going the wrong way. They're going all the way back here to take care of that pylon instead of running up here. And there's no way they would have made it here before the Zealot showed up. But SOS just being very cautious, playing very safely. In tournament situations like this, you definitely want to be as safe as you can. So here come the Lings knocking down the pylon. And here comes the drone, keeping the drone outside of the vision of that pylon and then throwing down the hatch. This way, SOS is not sure if the hatch is down or not. If he sees the drone coming on in before the pylon dies, then he knows, okay, a hatch is coming down. But as it stands, Nurchio is going to keep him guessing just a little bit. So APM for these players is over 200 to the point on average and currently. Lings checking to make sure there's not a third Nexus, which would be moderately insane. But again, SOS is playing too safe for that to happen. But it is a Stargate opening. Oh, man. We've seen Stargate openings cause lots and lots of trouble for Zerg here as of late. So we will have to see if Nurchio is going to be able to handle this. He is going for that third hatch, and on this map it makes a lot of sense to do so. Continuing to make drones, he is actually down 27 to 34 harvesters. Getting speed, getting some queens. And there we go, now 6 drones on the way. The full power of that Zerg macro is on display here. Where is that mothership core? Did I see one come out? I don't know. Does SOS have a mothership core? Yes, he does. Where is it? There it is. Ah, it's way down here. Okay, so this again is on the latest patch, Mothership Core. Some people have said they prefer Mamaship Core. Others prefer Mothership Core. And you know what? I'm going to go with Mothership Core. Mama was never really anything that I said to my mom when I was a kid. She's always Mom. And Mama, it doesn't work for me. So we're going to go Mothership Core. Apologies to those of you who did request it on the channel. Can't make everybody happy. We're going to go Mothership Core from now on, even if it is a little bit easier. More difficult to actually say, depending on how you look at it. Either way, Mothership Core. Phoenix taking down an Overlord. Just trying to scout in with this. Going to say, oh, look, there's a Stargate, obviously, because derp. There's a Phoenix that is killing me. Sees another Phoenix come out, though, before he dies, and recognizes another Phoenix is on the way. So the Phoenix ball is going to be a big deal. We should see Nurchio throw down some Spore Crawlers here very, very soon. He's going Roach, though. Roachworn, more Overlords getting taken out here. Will Nurchio be supply blocked? He will. He will temporarily be supply blocked. He does actually not have any Overlords in production either. What's going on, Nurchio? Nurchio, you need to have overlords, man. Alright, not really worrying about the supply block. There we go, now he's got three of them coming. But for a second there, I didn't think he was. So Phoenix popping on in. And again, there's not a spore crawler here. What is happening? There's one in the main. He's not worried about it in the third or the second base for whatever reason. Losing another overlord. Not supply blocked. Whew, because again, getting that overlord production up here to replace the ones ahead of the time that he actually loses the ones that are out here. Phoenix trying to fly in, but there is a queen. There is a spore crawler. Gonna lose a Phoenix if you're not careful. There you go. Get on out of there. I think they killed a single drone, but that is about it. Another Phoenix coming into that Phoenix ball. Total number of Phoenix out in the field is 4, with another one on the way. 5 is usually where Protoss players will stick, but if they want to go for a big old cloud, it can make sense to double. Robotics facility coming up as well. Sporecrawler not quite here yet. 2 queens trying to stab away at these Phoenix. Again, the Sporecrawler a little bit late there. This Sporecrawler is up and ready to go, but only 1 queen here. Evolution chamber on the way. Robotics facility, double robotics facility here for SOS. And a Twilight Council. So what this build does, we've seen this quite a bit. I believe Myunshik kind of pioneered this in Legacy of the Void. I want to say back in December of last year. Go for a Phoenix Ball, force the Zerg player to get things like Hydras, and then just show up with a whole bunch of Disruptors, and just nothing much that can deal with that Disruptor and Immortals and things like that. 3 drones on the gasket picked up, more drones along this mineral line, just absolutely getting eaten here. Nurchio losing workers like there's no tomorrow. Wow, how many drones have died? 10 drones have died already to these Phoenix. I think they definitely have paid for themselves. Are they going to kill this Overlord too? Yes, killing the Overlord, not losing another Phoenix. Double Spore Crawler here, though. At this point, Nurchio recognizes this Phoenix Cloud is big enough to be a harassment. To be a harassment. 4th base on the way for Nurchio here. 3rd base all the way up and established. Immortal and +2 attack being researched. Templar Archives, rather, not a Twilight Council. Templar Archives and Zealot Legs being researched for SOS. A whole bunch of gateways. And here we go, turning those into warp gates. It looks like someone's gearing up for an attack, and I don't think it's going to be Nurchio. He is going right for that lurker composition. The Hydras are here. Are there enough Hydras? Yes, it's enough to shoo away the Phoenix temporarily. Although, no, they come right on in, pick up the Hydras. More Hydras come on in, though. The Sporecrawler getting shots off, too, trying to kill as many of these as they can. No, the Phoenix will not stick around for that to happen. 1 Phoenix died, 3 Hydras died. Excellent, excellent play indeed. And these guys walking onto the creep, some Zealots, some Immortals. Again, this composition not that great against Hydra, so I'm not sure why SOS is going for this particular deal. Mass Hydra does great against all 3 of these units, trying to kill some creep tumors, trying to push that there creep back. It's a Ling Hydra composition sniping down the hallucinated Phoenix, and actually might try to get a surround here, but 3 Immortals and an Archon. There we go. The Archon is exactly what he needs. Time Warp being thrown down, and the Hydras decide to head on home. Some Lings are up here trying to kill a Nexus all by themselves, but nope, the one Ling does get taken on down. It is 4 base to 3 base, though, right now. So, 74 to 69 Harvesters. Nurchio did lose those drones, but has replaced them and then some. This base is not quite saturated yet, but here comes the Lurker production. Here comes some Spore Crawlers up at the front to deal with any Phoenix that decide to show up. Will the attack arrive before those Spore Crawlers finish? I don't think so. Spores don't take that long to finish building there. Looks like about 21 seconds. Pop and pop. Ooh, I like the Infestor play from Nurchio. So, Infestor Hydra. And here comes the attack, lifting up all of the Lurkers first, forcing them to re-burrow. Archons mowing through everything. The Zealots at the front lines actually catching Infestors out of position. Lurkers dying. There is an Observer with this army. Huge, huge push forward from Nurchio, or from SOS. Nurchio just doesn't have anything left. He has some Hydralisks, but they get killed instantly. Some Lynx trying to come from the backside and snipe down an Immortal, perhaps. But no, lifting the Immortal to keep it alive. What a play by SOS. Every single Ling is dead here, and that's it. A GG from Nurchio. Nurchio is defeated. SOS is victorious, and Nurchio has left the game. What an absolutely amazing composition there from SOS. Bringing in Phoenix to lift up the Lurkers. Lurkers were entirely useless in that battle. The Archons cleaning up any Lings that happen to be here. Immortals, just in case there were Roaches. And Archons, too, smashing through everything with their plus damage versus biological. +2 had finished. 43 damage versus biological and splash. No less. So just a brilliant, brilliant opening executing move here from SOS. Basically going to go ahead and go up 1-0 here. Not basically, he is. He's up 1-0 in this best of 5, looking very strong doing so. Will Nurchio be able to come back and make this a series, or is SOS just destined to romp Tune in tomorrow at 5 p.m. Eastern. No, 7 p.m. Eastern. I apologize. 7 p.m. Eastern to see what we can see. And that's it for me. So this is Falcon Paladin coming to you with yet another daily Legacy of the Void upload. Hit that like button. Hit that subscribe if you like what you saw and what you heard today. You can also catch me on Twitter and Facebook, both at /FalconPaladin. And until next time, as always, thank you so much for watching, and you take care of yourself.